right, YouTube, hope y'all can hear me good. I'm at this truck stop. I'm shut down for 10 hours, so I decided to do this quick video. A lot of people been requesting it. This video gonna be about the about maintenance and equipment. This right here is a 2013 International Max Force. Okay, so it's a dual stock. Okay, so the video is about, please, if you can, do not purchase a Max Force. This truck was purchased down in Florida for the price of $45,000. Of course, you know, all the trucks are up right now. So that's why I mentioned before, you know, a lot of people, you know, purchasing trucks at high prices, which is, that's nothing that we can control, because if somebody gonna sell a truck, of course they're gonna mark the price up as a high demand. But you can control what truck you buy. Like I said, I can't stress it enough. I highly recommend that you don't buy no Max Force. But if you choose to buy it, this video is gonna show you the things that could possibly go wrong with it. So, when we first purchased this truck, the very next day, once it arrived, we took it down to get a DOT inspection, and it failed. I think they say it had a low compression on the motor and some more stuff. So, we requested to get a new motor put in. They said that they do not have any new engines. So, we went with a rebuilt engine. And they said that engine that was in this truck was so bad, they couldn't rebuild a block. So, we had to go buy a used block for them to rebuild. Long story short, purchased the truck, I think it was November, got on the road in November, went out on it, only had it for a week, it broke down, put it in the shop for about 2 weeks, got it out, drove for about another week, it broke down, put it in another shop, got it out, same thing, about another week, it broke down. So, when I mean break down, our problem was, once you turn the truck off, you try to turn it back on, it just crank over. It won't actually crank. Okay, it just turn over, but it won't crank. That what happened every time. So, to walk y'all through the process of what was the problems, originally, this relay right here, they thought the relay was bad, which is well bad. It was busted a little bit, but anyway, they replaced the relay. Like I said, I took it out after they fixed it the first time. A week later, it messed up again. Kind of found out it was still the same relay. What it was, this wiring in it was loose. So, you know, this the pins was loose. So they replaced that. And, you know, like I said, once it did it the second time, went took it to another. Each time it went to a different international. It depend on where I was at. One time it was in Portland, Oregon. Another time it was in outside of Kansas City, Missouri. Another time it was in Kentucky. So it was different place each time. So the first time, like I say, they replaced. Also, one place was in Montgomery, Alabama. But so they replaced this the first time, the relay. Yeah, I did it again, kind of find out the relay was loose. So they had a zip tie on it. And eventually they actually redid the wiring on that. So the second time we took it to the shop, they said, it's a wiring problem. So they replaced every wire on this motor. They replaced wires up here at my relays. I think my battery box, they replaced some wires. As you can see some new wirings, and the wires that were good, they call themselves going all the way back and traced every wire that was bad. So they replaced all the bad wiring. Okay, so it did the same thing the third time. So the third time, they said it was the ECM. It was a bad ECM on there. So they had replaced the computer. When they replaced the computer, they said, that should cover everything. So at that point, we had new relays, new wires, new computer, new ECM. So the fourth time, like I said, this, each time it got, get out the saw, like it only lasts a week. The fourth time, they said the previous international had some pins messed up. Well, they said that they say they didn't install the ELD correctly. It had some mixed pins, and also they had to replace a lot of pins on these wires. The wires been changed, but they had to replace the pins because they said the connections was loose on there. So that's the fourth time. Like I said, we finna take it in again a fifth time. As y'all can see, which I didn't get to it yet, this motor is soaking wet. It is a bad oil leak on it somewhere. Don't know where it's coming from. This truck been sitting, I've been sitting here for a few hours. I can show you some leaks that happened since I've been sitting here. So I'm trying to get under it, hope it's a good view. Y'all can see how wet, matter of fact, and it is leaking right now. Look how wet that bottom of that pan is. So like I say, so now we gotta take it back to the original shop who rebuilt this motor, and that should be under warranty. So all that work we had done, what I had mentioned, none of it was under warranty. Each time they say, that part wasn't under warranty, that part was under warranty. And also I missed some stuff too. We replaced that throttle valve sensor. It's a lot more stuff we replaced. So this also might be helpful to people who having problems if your truck not cranking. Some stuff might be obvious or common sense, as you might say. Some might not be. So y'all excuse me, this is an unplanned video, so truck might not be to y'all standards, might be a little messy. Because I live in this truck, this is where I sleep at. But if you ever get in a situation where you try to crank your truck, I'm gonna let it go through the cycle first. So yesterday you try to crank it and it don't crank at all, don't make no noise. You would probably hear some clicking going on over there in the fuse panel box. Don't panic, because all it is that you knock your truck out of gear. Probably when you were sleeping in here like me. So you just gotta put it back in neutral and then crank it up. So that's one thing to cover if you're trying to start the truck and it don't crank over at all. Okay, another thing, and this come from spending a lot of money, and some problem might be simple, some might be major. Another thing too, if you try to crank your truck, if you try to turn it over and it crank but it don't start, get under here and check all these fuses. Check this fuse, and it's about 1, 2, 3, 4. And four more fuses on that. You want to check all your, before you call anybody out, you know, check your fuses. Check, make sure your battery connection is tight. Okay? Then also come up here and check this relay. You know, this don't cost nothing. It's cheaper to just go ahead and, matter of fact, you want to have some extra relays anyway. So if you having this problem where the turnover won't crank, just go ahead and go to International and purchase you a relay. So check that first, check your fuses, and that should be your problem. If that's not the problem, then it go deeper than that. It might be inside your tank, or might be some kind of electrical problem like our situation was. It could be your throttle valve sensor. It could be more, you know what I'm saying? They'll have to go in and put it on the computer and try to find out. But the main point of me making this video today, y'all, I didn't want to make it too long, but the point was, please pay attention on the truck you buying. Like I said, I guess I'll put this as a part two of the do's and don't. So a don't is do not buy a Max Force. Please don't. If you do, like I said, that's on you. You'll find out the hard way. You can listen, you don't listen, you know. It's you the owner, so it's up to you to figure it out. Also, like I mentioned in the previous video, you wanna make sure you have a 26-foot dark high box truck. Again, that's a 26-foot dark high box truck. Also, you wanna make sure you take measurements of your inside dimension of your box from floor to door. So from the floor to the top of your door of the inside of your box, you wanna measure that and know your dimensions on that. You wanna make sure you have you a full size lift gate. I guess I'll show y'all all this stuff. I'm not loaded. I didn't want to try to make the video too long. Gotta get me a broom to clean this box out, man. These shippers, they'll put all this packing and stuff inside your box truck. And then once they take it out of there, you left with a whole bunch of trash. So I gotta get me a broom and sweep this out of here. So like I said, you wanna measure from the floor to the top of the door up here. That'll give you your inside dimensions that you wanna do from wall to wall. So like I said, the broker asks for these things. That is really mandatory that you have the correct measurements. So when I first got out here, I arrived at plenty of shippers where the person either lied or didn't get the correct measurements. They get there, they can't get the load on because the pallet too high, or they show up, which I think is crazy, but you got some people out there who might do it. They might show up with a non-dark high box truck. So, you know, they only have docks, so they have no way of loading that load on there. So you don't wanna do that. That's two things you don't wanna do. You don't wanna have no non-dark high truck, and you don't wanna have a small lift gate. We're gonna get to that next. Also, you know, once you get going, you'll find out you need to have some shipping blankets. You wanna have your tie-down scraps. I highly recommend do not get any of these smaller ones. You wanna get these heavy-duty ones, but you don't wanna get these right here. You wanna put you a, what they call an E-track. E-track or run along this truck. If you ever had a rental truck from Penske, you'll understand what I'm talking about. But the E-track run along the side, and then it just come with a little hook where you hook it into the E-track. So you wanna make sure you have E-scraps and E-tracks, okay? E-track scraps and E-tracks. Like I said, I'm making do with this. And when I mount these, I don't hook it like that because it comes loose. I hook it on there like this. But you have a stronger hold. But the point is, if you're gonna do stuff the right way, don't get these. Get you some E-tracks put in if you don't have none installed, and get you the E-tracks scraps. Load locks, you're gonna need some load locks. You're gonna need at least minimum of two load locks. And some places require you to have about six scraps, but you at least want to start off with two scraps and two load locks. And then, like I said, if you need more, you can already purchase more once you're on your way to that load. So that's not nothing like that real mandatory. We originally installed a backup camera on here, which is not hooked up at the time. I don't use it. I'm really experienced with bagging up, so I don't need it. So if you're not experienced with bagging up, they make backup cameras. Let me see, can I let this lift gate down? All right, so this is lift gate. Like this switch up here with use, and it come down. Do not purchase no truck with no small lift gate like this. If you think you're getting a good deal on a truck, and you like the truck, get it, but make sure you take this lift gate off before you try to operate. Like I said, this lift gate is the smaller lift gate they make. You cannot do nothing with this lift gate. So don't attempt to try to do anything with it, especially if you're not experienced. Don't try to do anything with this lift gate. So like I said, it's too small and you can't get most of your loads on here. So you'll be wasting your time. Unless you just feel like damaging a shipper product, don't get this lift gate. I think that might cover all the do's and don'ts. Like I said, I can always add more. I didn't plan on making this video, so I'm not gonna make it so long. I don't feel like doing a lot of editing. But if y'all have any more requests, just let me know and I'll take the time to try to make the video for you all. As always, this is Life Journey. I appreciate y'all for taking the time to watch my videos. I just want y'all to keep liking, comment, and you know, get people to subscribe to the channel. We try to grow this channel. Like I say, I'm new at this. I've been, you know, making major progress as I've been, you know, posting videos. I've been learning the, you know, stuff I messed up at, and y'all been telling me different things to help me out. I appreciate y'all. Like I said, as always, just continue to follow this journey we on, and want y'all to be, stay blessed, man. Cause you gotta through all this stuff you go to, man, you gotta just keep the faith and pray about it, and just, man, and just appreciate your blessing. Appreciate the good and the bad. Cause you just go around being joyful for the good, and when bad comes, you come complaining and oh man, this is all this stuff happened to me, man. You ain't gonna get out of that situation, man. You got to just stay positive, keep going through it, and learn. You got to learn from it. You don't learn anything from your mistakes and problems, you will continue to go through them. You'll continue to go through them because you're not learning. You get put in a certain situation for a reason sometimes. You know, everything happened for a reason. You know, timing is everything, and the way this universe works, man, a lot of stuff happened for a reason. It's up to you to learn from your mistakes. So, appreciate y'all for watching. Y'all be blessed.